your non-practice game? Is this about where you feel like you want to be at this point in the pre-practice?
I don't think it's, you know, you always want to appreciate your craft, but I think that it's also getting better each and every day. So my personal development is also getting better each and every day. Feeling, for myself and how anybody else. So I want to continue to try to get better each and every day and continue to get the guys around me.
Coach Miles kind of gave you the advantage as far as the scrimmage this past weekend. You said that Brandon might have had the advantage the previous weekend. What do you think you did differently to give get the nod as far as with the guys on the weekend?
I just wanted to come in and see my play that I had throughout the scrimmage, encourage the guys around me, not turn the ball over, trying to make more and more decisions in the scrimmage. I just wanted to come in and get better in that practice.
I think with Saban last week, you're talking about between you guys, the two of you on the field, but you know, as long as they don't look at you, they don't even change how who's in the game just because there's so many similarities. Do you think that there's certain things that you do better than him and certain things that he might do better than you? What were those two kind of doing?
I can't say it. Both of us, me and Brandon, we come in and practice, enthusiastic about practice each and every day, trying to get better. And I think me and him, obviously, some differences. So I think that, any quarterback that's back there, we want to, seem similar to the fact that executing plays properly, getting the plays, communicating to the guys. I think me and Brandon do that pretty well.
With there being a competition, do you look at that as a positive thing? Do you think that drives y'all to be better?
Yeah, I think, competition within ourselves and competition with the quarterback group, I think that the most important thing is competition with yourself and getting better each and every day. Exceeding what you did the previous day. That's just very important. Getting better each and every day is what Tommy Marcus, Coach Miles, he does that. Coach Cameron also does that. So getting better each and every day is very important.
So with all your experience, you feel you're learning fast enough?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I think that I'm more comfortable than I ever been. Telling guys what to do, telling them how to line up, and what kind of thing. It comes easy to me. I don't really have to think about, okay, what am I doing this place? I go out there and tell other guys what to do, tell them how to get lined up, snap count, things like that. It comes easy to me.
You're getting a little bit more freedom with the offense now?
We put in installs each and every day, so each guy is getting, each guy on the offense is getting what we need to do. New plays, each play, all the plays that have been going in, we already have been running those plays previously.
Talk about DJ Clark a little bit. You think he's kind of emerging as a strong receiver?
Oh, definitely. He's one of the fastest guys on our team. He's one of the most explosive guys on our team. And I think that he's coming in with great confidence with himself, having back-to-back weeks, having great practices. He's staying later. He's working harder. I think that guy's going to be a threat coming through.
Hey, on the offensive side of the ball,
this defense is flying around the football. They're one of the fastest defenses. Those guys play with enthusiasm and effort. Those guys have the will to get better each day in practice, just like the offense. But I think that Coach Steele brings that excitement and defense. It's going to be very awesome.
Is there a difference between Coach Steele and Coach Saban?
I think those guys have their own unique styles, so I think they're both great coaches.
What about Coach O?
Oh, Coach O, you can hear him everywhere. He's a very enthusiastic guy. He obviously knows what he's talking about. He gets that D-line coming after me, trying to sack me. He's never practiced. So I like his coaching style, not because I can coach by him, but I see him coaching up there.
Talk about Justin McGill a little bit. I know he's been on campus for only a couple of weeks. What have you seen out of him that you like?
Oh, yeah. He's a guy that, if he doesn't know something, he'll ask me, he'll ask Brad, he'll ask Brandon, ask Coach Cam, he'll stop with me and say, okay, what does this actually mean? Because other guys get it, know it already. But he stops and asks questions, he says, eager to learn. He comes to me by my dorm and asks me, okay, what does this play mean? What are the routes here? What are the progressions? So he's very eager to learn, and he's coming out there and just being confident.
What's been the difference from this spring from last spring?
I think there's more, I'm more comfortable with the playbook. I'm more comfortable with the guys around me. I'm playing out of myself into the team. And that's what you have to do to get those guys to rally around you and to play better. We have those every camp, football fall camp, we have various people come in and talk about social media. We had Michael Irvin come and talk to us from the team aspect. We want to be smart teams, stay smart teams, and always encourage and say things that you'll regret. I think that he preaches. He didn't have a couple seasons that he didn't do very well. He said that the team made a commitment to themselves that they were going to be together and as one. That's what he kind of preached to this team, to be together. So we had this time of year to go as far as we want to go. Just basically committed to ourselves, committed to this program that we'll play together and we'll be good. I see all that kind of stuff. I have Twitter, I have Instagram, but that's not my focus. I mean, people from the outside world don't really, affect me, because I know here in the building is what really matters. A lot of people want to say a lot of things, good, to bad, to ugly. You just have to remain focused.
Anthony, you hit Deshaun with about 4 or 5 passes, I guess, in the bowl game. What you guys look at chemistry looking like right now in spring?
Oh, yeah, definitely. He's coming in with a great mindset, building more confidence from that game. He continues to grow as a player, as a blocker. And I think that me and him, the chemistry continues to be getting better throughout the practices throughout spring and summer workouts.
You guys hope they involve the tight end more in the offense this summer season?
Oh, definitely. Well, we have great tight ends that can run and catch the ball. Colin Keenan, Corey Washington, also those guys can run and catch the football. And we want to get those guys into the offense.